everyone, and welcome to ScorchTV vlog. I know I really dropped the ball. I haven't been doing many. Had a few things in life come up. Everyone can understand that. And then, based on some of my personal things going on in life and things like that, I kind of had to decide where I wanted to go with this next, not just the vlog, but ScorchTV as a whole. And even more so, me racing as much, the ScorchTV chase car and so forth. This is a big decision. I was gonna ask for everyone's input, but it usually stems off into drama and haters and people's whose opinion you don't really value, and you miss out on the core audience that you do value because of that. Instead, I took a lot of time and deliberation as far as, you know, what to do. Obviously, my focus is always to bring the best footage I can to the audience and display it in a way that you feel that you're there. Obviously, I can't compete with some of the bigger people because I don't have a big team as they do and so forth. But I try to keep the quality as high as possible, as opposed to the quantity, as I can't cover as much as other people. I do have, other things in life that I do as well besides this. So with this next part, as you can see, there's no cars in the garage now. The Viper, sorry. The Viper is sold. So that was a bit hard to do. I really love Vipers. They just give off a completely different experience. I know the number one question I get is, so what's the difference between the Vet and the Viper? Which one do you like more? Well, I like them both. They both have their own qualities and characteristics that make them what they are. So it's pretty much like comparing apples to oranges. I, for one, can't. But, you know, and with all that said and done, the Viper did sell. It's going to a great home. I'll be delivering it here myself in a day or two. Aside from that, I went ahead and made another purchase to start off with again. I'm not sure that I will be doing a build, as at the end of my decision making, I realized that excuse me, it's easier for me to attend events and cover them than trying to race, maintain a race car, and cover an event. It's just one of those things where you can only get so much done. I know a lot of my videos used to be me racing. I started off as, then it grew into a bigger brand. Now I'm filming, you know, other people racing and other things happening, and now vlog and so forth. So I'm trying to branch out more instead of locking myself in. At the end of the day, it gives me more time to get you guys better footage, other contenders, and so forth. That doesn't mean that I won't have a fast car. I just won't be racing as much. So, you know, that was a hard decision. And those are some of the things that helped me decide where I wanted to go with it. Now factoring in a new car. So these are some guidelines I use when I'm going to purchase a new car, which I build a car almost every winter for the past 10 years. So it will kind of take a lot off my back, not having the pressure on myself to do a build during the winter, and having to make sure it's ready to race with TX2K and all this other stuff. So free up a lot of time for other things in life, as well as getting more content, different content and so forth. So some of the guidelines that I do use for buying a car are, for one, a good base. you know, can I mod this? Can I swap an engine? Can I turbocharge it? You know, how good is the chassis? What's the condition of the car? Is it something I could see myself driving for a long time? You know, am I building a drag car? Am I building a daily driver? Am I building a street car? So for this part, I chose to get something that I can build. I can engine swap later. I can turbocharge later if I want. But I wanted something that was comfortable, that I could still look okay in. You know, I didn't get a some type of beater or something. It's Geo Metro. But that was a big thing to me, to get something that I could still show to, you know, car shows or whatever, and have something that I could still connect with the community. But at the same time, something I could drive on a daily basis and not have to worry about noise or heat or, you know, clutches or warming it up 15, 20 minutes before I can actually leave so that the oil is, you know, up to temperature so this, the brittle springs don't break in the winter. Another big one was, you know, having something I can drive in any weather. Now, my cars, I usually build street cars, so I can drive them whenever. But once you get up to the higher horsepower ratings and stuff, you know, you don't want to get caught in a rear-wheel drive car with slicks or drag radios sometimes, you know. Even if they can drive in the rain, depending on where you live, for here example, when it rains in the summer, all the oil gets brought up to the surface. So it doesn't matter if you have tread on the tires or what. If they're drags, if they're slicks, it's gonna hydroplane a little bit. The tail end is gonna want to shimmy as you're driving. So those things were taken into account, and it left me with the all-wheel drive platform. Now, I've had an Evo before, 700 horsepower. I hated it. I tried to do a clutch swap on it. I hated that too. But this one's a bit different. It's more accessible. And it's no different really than any of the other builds I did. It's just got a couple other little things that have to get done as far as drivetrain wise to support power. And obviously, to get power, you need force induction or whatever your choice is. So those are some of the things that went into accounting for my decision now. I mean, when you're buying a car, you know, don't rush buying process. Research. Make sure you have your goal in mind, not only short term, but long term. What I always tell people is don't buy a car that's not a good base. And what I mean by that is don't buy a G8 or something like that and then complain about Corvettes and other lighter cars that are actually meant more for that particular goal, which is racing or going, you know, eights or sevens. You know, if you want to go fast or you want a good base to build off of, don't buy something and then, you know, spend three or four times the amount that it would take you off a other base. Now, that's not saying the G8s are bad or any of the other cars are bad. You know, everyone has their tastes and goals, etc. Just saying, pick a right base. Don't pick a V6 over, you know, a V8 if you're looking for power and so forth. So I hope that kind of makes sense what I'm trying to articulate here. So those are some of the changes coming to Scorch TV. Have a few other surprises in store. And as far as the vlogs will go, you'll see less and less of me just sitting here talking to the camera, and more action, more behind the scenes, you know, more product showcases where you can actually see what the product is, how it works, etc. and obviously more of the car and more of the griminess that comes behind all the street racing stuff that a lot of people don't post, but is usually the best stuff to post. So I'll leave you with this brief vlog. I hope you guys enjoy it. And yeah, meet the new chase car. Bye.